amount of user-generated content, who can be now defined as a journalist and what's the role that he might have?
I'm less interested in who we call journalists than what we call journalism. And anybody who has a brain and a camera and a notebook can do an act of journalism, can be part of the process. And how we put things together is in a way more important than the definition of journalist. So I think we can all be part of the journalism ecosystem, and some people are more directly part than others.
There has been an ongoing discussion about the social media presence mm-hmm. of journalists that are openly discussing their political stance. Mm-hmm. Where is the fine line between having the power to sway public's opinion as a journalist and expressing personal opinion?
Well, this is part of what I talked about today. I think transparency goes a long way toward helping people who are our audiences to understand where we're coming from and to understand what we do as a result of that. I think at the same time, there are some people I would not be advising to say what they think about everything that they write or broadcast about. I think this is a call that individuals and individual organizations need to make based on their own standards.
During the event, you talk about why journalists should become activists. Let's assume that the majority of journalists become activists. How do we preserve the balance in journalistic production?
Well, what I was saying, that I think journalists should be activists on only a few core issues about freedom of expression and basic human liberties. At the same time, and that on those we cannot be neutral and should not pretend to be. I do welcome and enjoy journalism where it's not obvious to me what the viewpoint of the writer or broadcaster is. But I also, again, believe transparency solves a lot of the problems because people really should not rely on a single source of information in any case. We should, on any topic, read more than one thing, and ideally things by opposing viewpoints. So while I still think there's plenty of room for journalism that tries to be neutral, and we should certainly welcome it, we have more choices now and we can arrive at our conclusions based on different points of view.
You talked about journalists opposing mass surveillance. Can you give any practical advice? What can a journalist actually do?
Well, journalists should start by using more security precautions themselves, starting with encryption, and taking care not to do things that put their sources in jeopardy, which surveillance certainly does. I think journalists should also help educate the public about what the rest of us can do to be safer in our communications, and it seems to me like a good role for journalists.
Just as the last question, in what ways does activism help journalistic production? And do you see any danger in harming the reputation of journalism, or just there's the opposite?
Well, I don't know the answer to that question because we haven't seen it. I don't think that the activism of, for example, The Guardian on climate change is causing anyone to say, oh, that Guardian, I can't trust them anymore. I think, in fact, right now, my bias is to trust them even more.
Thank you very much.